Hey guys, this is Janine from Panglim. Welcome back to my Lightroom course for wildlife photographers. If you're just getting set up, you might wonder what you should do. Shoot RAW, shoot JPEG? We want to discuss that question today and see what might work better for you. Versus JPEG is a never-ending question, and there is a lot of different opinions out there. I want to explain to you the basic difference and show it on an example that you can download on our homepage when signing up for our Lightroom course. Before we get started, I would like to explain to you the basic difference on a metaphor. Have you ever baked a cake to one of your loved ones? Nope. Have you bought a cake for any of your loved ones? That is now the fundamental difference. You can either go to the supermarket and buy a beautifully baked cake that looks impeccable and bring it home for a birthday or a wedding, whatever the occasion is. Or you can now go and bake it yourself. It might not look just as impeccable, but you know the person might have a nut allergy and cannot have almonds. Or they don't like too much sugar. They would rather replace sugar with stevia. Or they're just insane chocolate lovers and you put so much chocolate into this cake. That is the difference between JPEG, the finished product, and RAW, the ingredients that you still have to put together. So now it depends on how much time you want to spend with your photographs. But because you are watching a Lightroom course, I assume that you have an interest in looking at your pictures after you've shot them. So when you shoot a RAW file, you cannot simply make use of that file. You cannot post it on social media or print it right away because it is not finished baking. You will have to put it together, do a quick edit, and then export it first. While a JPEG, you can take off your memory card and put straight onto social media. That might sound a lot easier, but maybe the finished product isn't quite what you liked. Also remember that you will go through your photographs anyways, looking at what is best. If you would like help on how to choose the best photograph, there's other modules in this Lightroom course that you can have a look at. And if you want to know how to quickly edit a photograph, just the basics, so that you can export it as a JPEG, there's also a module for that. Check out the links just down below. But to make this more clear to you, I would like you to look at the example that you could download from our homepage. I provided you with a fish eel that was busy eating a fish, both as a RAW file as well as a JPEG file. My RAW files are called CR2 files. There's only one RAW file that is sort of a global RAW file. It's called a DNG file. However, it hasn't really pushed its way through to all the different camera brands. So coming back to my example, RAW files tend to be a bit blonde, but in general, the light was gorgeous that night and it is quite a beautiful picture. I just lost a little bit of the details on the neck of the fish eagle. It's a crooked horizon and I find the temperature is a little bit too warm. So let's go through the basic editing steps. If you would need some help with that, please check out the other Lightroom module and you'll be able to follow me quickly. So first, I would like to straighten out this horizon. I would like this fish eagle to sit a little bit more towards the left because I feel he is turning his body, opening his body towards the right. And there we go, maybe a tiny bit more. I feel there's too much grass. The grass is a lot more destructive than what the background is. So that is quite nice. We open our basic panel. We're going to adjust our whites and our blacks. And you'll see it becomes more and more yellow, not necessarily nice, but this is in theory a perfect exposure. So now we can quickly adjust the temperature to make sure this looks a little bit more natural. I love that it was shot in the late evening light, but we don't want it to yellow. We can even increase our clarity a little bit. Make sure this image is sharp. And that is pretty much all we need to do to this image. If we have a look on one-on-one, you can see it is mostly focused on the fish, actually, more than the fish eagle. But in general, I'm quite happy with it. So now I would like to implement the exact same editing changes to our JPEG file. There is a trick. We can simply press copy on the bottom left corner in our development mode. We can choose which settings to copy. Normally the local adjustments and the crop are taken out. Make sure that crop is specifically ticked so that you don't have to recrop it and it looks exactly the same. That way you can copy. You go over to your JPEG and you paste these settings on your JPEG image. I'm now going to go to the library panel, because in the library panel we can compare images parallel to each other. And if we compare these two zoomed in on one-on-one, we can see that when editing our basic settings, the image is pretty much identical. There isn't a drastic difference in the two images. You could say that the JPEG file is a bit sharper because it has been sharpened as it was created already and we resharpened it. Also, I find that the yellow tone in the chest is a little bit more obvious. This side looks a little bit more natural, but it isn't a horrible difference between the two. Looking more into detail, you can also see that the pixelation in our JPEG is a lot stronger. So masking our image worked a lot better on the RAW file. However, let's go back into our development mode and edit this image a little bit further. We have chosen the temperature panel in order to adjust our temperature. However, that is not always the most accurate panel. A lot of times people would like to work with the HSL color panel and just simply adjust the yellows a little bit as they need to by changing the luminance, making sure the yellow is not too overbearing but still existent. And the same with the orange and red tones in this image. You will make sure it just looks a bit more natural. I'll take the overall exposure down a bit so that the white is back. By playing with the individual colors in the image, you can make the image a lot more contrasty and take the yellow out completely without losing the saturation in the red wing feathers, the green of the grass, or that beautiful orange in the background. Let's copy these settings right back on to our JPEG file and compare the difference once again. If we compare the two images now, the difference between the yellow, the dirty look in the chest, between the JPEG and the CR2 file has gotten stronger. At the same time, I don't feel that we lost any saturation in the blues or the reds of the wings. So when it comes to fine-tuning the colors, our RAW file has a lot more data to work with in order to get what we initially wanted. Our JPEG files, when it comes to changing the exposures by several stops, when it comes to trying to get the highlights out of the whites back, when it comes to fine-tuning the colors, will not be able to be just as refined. Is that important to you? Do you print large formats? Do you make coffee table books? Would you like your image to be perfect the way you want it? Or are you happy with what the image is proposing to look like? That depends on you, really. If you're a wildlife photographer that just wants to take some happy snappies and take some memory shots home, JPEG is perfect for you. Why waste time on fine-tuning every single image that you enjoy? However, if you want to learn more about your own photography, a RAW file can teach you a lot about color, color space, the dynamic range, your exposure. You have a lot more range to work in. And especially when we come to more advanced techniques, when it comes to pushing our exposure limits, the JPEG files will start struggling. So a lot of photographers shoot a RAW and JPEG on the card, either on one card or they have two cards in their camera body and shoot parallel. Why do you do that? In my opinion, it's a waste of space. If you shoot the RAW anyway and you end up going into your favorite image and editing it, then the JPEG was redundant. Some people do it so they can quickly look through the images, let's say on an iPad, and then choose what they like. That could work maybe, but in general, I find it's a fear that people are too worried to shoot RAW and that they won't be able to handle the RAW and deal with the RAW file afterwards, so they shoot the JPEG as a backup. After watching this Lightroom course, you'll be able to handle RAW files just fine. So I suggest you try it. Maybe it's a slow transition because you can create true artwork with it. I hope this module clarified the difference between RAW and JPEG for you. You might have something to think about now. Sit down, relax, let it run through your head, and I see you for the next module. Bye-bye.